Hello, in this video I'm going to talk about some of the configurations that you can do in Bahmni for patient attributes. In the agenda we have configuring the display order of patient attribute and hiding the patient attribute from the screen, and a quick demo of how to do these configurations. Let's first start with the display order of patient attributes. So if you log in to OpenMRS, and so as we have already seen in another video, have to add a new person attribute and have to delete or retire. So click on administration at the top right, and you navigate to this page where you can see manage person attribute types under person. Click on that link. You will be navigated to a page where you can see the list of person attributes available, and you can make different changes to these particular attributes as well as add or delete existing attributes. So the display order in Bahmni registration page will follow this particular order that it is configured in. Like, let's say education is so secondary contact is followed by education, and primary contact is followed by secondary contact, and so on. So this is the order that it takes in to actually show these particular attributes in the patient registration page. So in the registration page, the order will follow left, right, and so on. Like we have seen, education details followed by secondary contact, and then father's or husband's name and secondary identifier. This is how it is configured in the OpenMRS: education, secondary contact, primary contact is right now not seen because it is hidden. We can see the configuration of how to hide this particular attribute later, but primary attribute, as we know that the description is something that gets displayed, it is followed after this particular secondary contact attribute. So let's say you would want to change any of the order that it is right now displayed. Like you want the father's or husband's name to be the starting patient attribute, followed by education. Just click on the checkbox that is left to the name of the person attribute. Right now, primary relative is the name of the attribute that I would like to change the order. Click on the checkbox, and then based on the requirement, you can choose to move up or move down. In my case, primary relative, I would like to see primary relative at the top, so I'm choosing to move up. So this is one level at a time. So if you want to move multiple levels, you have to actually choose to click on move up multiple times. Like primary relative has moved just one level up, and I would like to move a little more up. So I've clicked twice, and now choose again and click again. So I've clicked thrice, and now I'm choosing to click again. So after clicking four times, it has actually moved top of the education. Now to see these changes in the patient registration page, navigate to that page, just refresh the page. Before which, previously education details is the first one, followed by secondary contact at the right, and father's or husband's name. Now the change that we have made is to get father's or husband's name at the place of education details, and the education details will move right towards this. Let's refresh the page and see this, see the changes. Okay, so father's and husband's name has actually come at the top, followed by education details and secondary contact. Now let's say if you want to move any of the attribute down, you can choose to click down. Like education detail, if you want it to be below the secondary contact, check the box at the left of the name of the person attribute, click on move down. It has just come one level down, and I would like to move it further down, so click on move down again. You can click as many number of times as you want. Now to see the changes reflected, now the education details has to come in the place of secondary contact and vice versa. Refresh the page to see the changes. Now yes, further of husband's name followed by secondary contact followed by education details. So this is how you can choose the order of the person attributes But remember, it is always left followed by right, and so on. And let's quickly look at the second part of our agenda, hiding the person attributes. This is a configuration that you have to do in the Bahmni configuration files. Let's log into the box. I'm using Vagrant. Vagrant SSH is a command I'm using to actually log into that box. I'm switching to a root user. And now the configuration files are located at /var /bahmni_config /openmrs/apps/registration. So this is the location for the configuration file specific to registration app. So cd will actually navigate to that particular folder. So cd space the folder path, and if you can see, the current directory is registration. And now if you list the files in this particular folder, you have app.json, etc., and you have to make the changes in app.json. Open the file. I'm using vi editor. Vi app.json will actually open that particular file, and there are certain configurations here. And so there's a section called config, under which there's a section called hidden. And if you can see, previously we talked about this, primary contact is not coming up on the registration page because it is configured to be hidden. If you want to remove this, delete this particular entry and then click save. So let's see what changes we have done. In the config, previously primary contact is configured to be hidden. Now actually I removed that property so that it will be seen on the Bahmni registration page. Let's go back to Bahmni registration page, and right now you don't see primary contact here. Like, let's say refresh the page, and here you go, primary contact has come up on the screen. And if you want to hide any other property, so let's choose one of the property, for example primary relative. So you want to hide father's or husband's name from the registration page. So you have to use a name, not the description. So the name of the attribute is primary relative. Copy that value, go back to the configuration file. Under hidden, under attributes, you have to add another value. Insert and add a comma, and then add this value, and in quotations, okay, and then save. And we can recheck whether the changes are done properly. So we right now have class cast and primary, sorry, we have to add primary relative. Let's copy it again, save. Okay, now go back to Bahmni registration page. Primary relative, the description of primary relative is father's or husband's name. That is what is being displayed on the page. So now we have configured to hide this particular field. So to see the changes getting reflected, refresh the page. Okay, see, that particular field is hidden right now. So the configuration for hiding the attributes is same throughout the sections. Like, you can choose to hide urban as well from additional patient information section. So let's see how to do that. If you want to hide urban, go back to OpenMRS manage person attribute types page, and urban, the description of urban is urban, and the attribute value, sorry, name is isurban. Copy that, go back to the configuration file, and it's the same place again. Click on check for hidden section. Under attributes, you have to configure another value, comma, and then value name in quotations is urban, and then click save. Let's recheck the changes. Right now we have configured 4 attributes to be hidden, and ezadmin is already there. Cool, let's go back to Bahmni registration page and refresh the page. Expand this section. Now ezadmin is already hidden. So here is the configuration to hide person attributes, to change the display order. And thank you for watching this video.